Okay, this is another test of game and development synSpace drone runners for Android. Again, it's a space game. You fly around, you shoot things. But we're going to talk about music again. So there's been some changes to the vocoder. So what we're going to do is we're going to start a recording using the vocoder. And then it's going to be Stairway to Heaven, so it's a nice song. Okay. All right, so that was the original, and of course that sounded great. And you saw the chords go by as it tried to decode them in real time. So now let's play the spectral recording back. This will not sound so great, and there's a lot of fans around right now because it's a hot day.
Thank you.
Okay, well, it still sounds like a very loud concert through a very thick wall, but that's okay. And okay, now that was using this thing called string bass 3. Well, I'm not sure what it was. Anyway, we're going to change it to a different instrument just to see how it sounds differently. Okay, so FM horns, and then we come over here. Band, and we replace the unknown instrument, and we replace the fun bass. Okay, now we play it again. Oops. Well, it's still a hot mess, but and see, it maxed out at 3,000 events again because it gets all of these sort of extra little micro notes, which you can delete easily enough. I mean, I could, if I wanted to. Well, if I knew what the key signature was. Anyway, so I can just delete. I'll just delete. Oops. Anyway, so you can get rid of things. You can move things around. Like, say, this whole section was, you deemed it was in the wrong place. I can move the whole thing up, move the whole thing down, move the whole thing to the right, move the whole thing to the left. Now, does that really work? Can I really do that? What happens when I let go? Huh, cool. And what happens when we play it? Should sound really weird. Well, okay, well, that's that. So the important things there were the new chord detector. So as the song plays, and it's any song. So let's play a different song. Oh wow. Well, here, let's do some actual chord progressions. Okay, this looks pretty good.
American big dude.
Okay, so this, the next voice you hear is going to be a guy who's playing chord progressions. Gotta plug him back in.
Minor feel to it, which is a nice contrast to the earlier two sets of four bars, and you know, contrasting things and creating that kind of artistic tension, if you like, that contrast brings is a really important point in building progression. Okay, let's just name those chords again. So we've got D minor, and back up to G again, and people are like, oh, when is, when is C going to come back? And it's at this point that your brain, even if you know nothing about music, really is really thinking, oh, well, you know, when are we going to come back to that C? But oh no, not yet. So we're going to go from G to the E minor, which is, kind of sounds a little bit like C, but we're not there. I'm teasing you a little bit because we're going then to A minor. It ends a little bit like C, has the shared notes. E minor shared notes with C, E and G. A minor shares the E and the C. But we're not back there yet. So you think, right, maybe now is the time to go back to C at the start of our final four bars, starting on bar 13. Yeah. Okay, but that's kind of unsatisfying. See how going from the A minor to the C doesn't work quite as well. The A minor wants to go somewhere else. Yeah. So.
Okay. That's all I wanted to show is this thing here, the so-called, what was called the rhythm rainbow, but it's now the chord rainbow. Thank you.